So today we are going to start biomolecules. Regular classes, whatever we are following over there, that only will do. Okay. So today we are starting biomolecules. Let's see how much we can finish. If we can finish this today itself, that would be good. Okay. Biomolecules. So what are biomolecules? Have you finished this chapter?
So we did it for biology last year.
Okay, last year. Okay. So biomolecules, basically, see in this chapter, because it is there in biology also. So basically all those, the structures of DNA and all you have already done in biology. Okay. But here we'll see the, you know, the reaction aspect of biomolecules, because it is chemistry. So we have to focus on reactions and structures. Okay. So that's what we are going to discuss here. Biomolecules are what? Biomolecules are the organic compound. So write down. These are the organic compounds present in biomolecules are the organic compounds present in present as, right? Don't present as essential constituent of living organism. Living organism in different cells. In different cells. Like I said, these are the organic compounds. These compounds mainly contains atoms like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, etc. Okay, so biomolecules, it is actually responsible, all these compounds, biomolecules, responsible for the, you know, for the building up, of all the living system. Responsible for the growth also, we can say. Responsible for growth or maintenance. It also provides the ability to reproduce. So all these things we have, it is because of biomolecules only. So biomolecules are basically the organic compound. Okay. Organic compound. Okay. Organic compounds, which are responsible for the growth of the living, you know, organism, building up of the living system we have, or it also provides the ability to reproduce. It mainly contains, these compounds mainly contains elements like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, sulfur, etc. Main constituents of this. Okay, this chapter, actually there are four different, you know, parts we have in this chapter. So mainly in this chapter we are going to discuss about carbohydrates. Like I said, four different parts we have. Carbohydrates, we'll talk about amino acids and proteins. This is important for chemistry point of view. Okay, we have nucleic acids also and lipids. Four different sections we have. Okay. For, for exam point of view, chemistry point of view, carbohydrates, amino acids are the most important part. Okay. So I think the first part here, that is carbohydrates. anyone can tell me, if you can tell me, what are carbohydrates? Mostly you'll get questions from here only. What are carbohydrates? Anyone?
Basically, just organic compounds that contain C, H, and O. So they're like the primary substrates for respiration.
Okay. Okay. So basically, the definition that you give, carbohydrates, like the name also suggests, it is the hydrates of carbon, right? Hydrates of carbon. This was the first kind of definition of carbohydrates we have. Hydrates of carbon. And the general representation of carbohydrates is in the form of the CXH2OY. This is the general representation of carbohydrates, CXH2OY, correct? So let us, see some examples, and then we'll see the new version or the new definition of carbohydrates. What is the problem in this definition we have? That we'll see first, and then we'll see the rectified, definition of carbohydrates. Okay, the new definition of carbohydrates. Okay, so this formula or this definition is not exactly correct. Why it is not correct? You see this example first. I am taking one example here, and that is HCHO. What is this? It is formaldehyde. Okay, and formaldehyde is not carbohydrate, first of all. Okay, but the formula representation of this, you see, can I write this as C1H2O1? Can I write this?
Yes, sir.
Where X and Y is nothing but one. So this is also the representation of formaldehyde, which is obviously not a carbohydrate. Another example, if I write down CH3, COOH, it is acetic acid. Okay, it is acetic acid, not a carbohydrate, obviously. And we can also write it as COH2O whole twice. Okay, again, the similar representation we have. Lactic acid. What is lactic acid? CH3, COH, HCOH. So if you see this, we can also write this as C3H2O whole thrice. Correct? 3, 4, 5, 6, 3, 2, 2, 6. Okay? This is lactic acid. So point is, these are not carbohydrates, but we can represent in this form. Right? CXH2OY in this form. Okay? Another, if I give you one more example here, there's one example of carbohydrate, and that is rhamnose. R-H-A-M-N-O-S-E. Rhamnose. Rhamnose is a carbohydrate, and its formula is 66H12O5. So this is a carbohydrate. Okay? But if you look at this formula, we cannot write this in the form of CXH2OY. This representation for carbohydrate is not possible. Understood? Right? So point is what? The initial definition of carbohydrates, that it is a hydrates of carbon, which can be represented in this form. So there are some other compounds also, aldehyde, acids, which can also represent in this form. And obviously they are not carbohydrates. One example we have of carbohydrate, that is rhamnose, right? Rhamnose formula is this, but this is a carbohydrate, but still it cannot represent in this form, which is the definition given by, right? So obviously there is a problem with this particular definition, Okay, we cannot define carbohydrates with this particular way, right? So that's why we have given a new definition of carbohydrates. Okay, and this definition is found to be wrong. Okay, this definition is found to be wrong, and hence we have given a new definition of carbohydrates. So what is the new definition, and the definition which you need to write in the exam if they ask is this only. So definition of carbohydrates, write down here. It is, these are the, all of you write down this definition. These are the optically active, polyhydroxy aldehyde or ketone. Optically active polyhydroxy aldehyde or ketone, which can also be broken down into small polyhydroxy aldehyde or ketones through hydrolysis. So this is the definition of carbohydrate: optically active polyhydroxy aldehyde or ketone, which can also be broken down into small polyhydroxy aldehyde or ketones through hydrolysis. Am I clear? What do you mean by polyhydroxy?
So more than one OH.
Yeah, two or more hydroxy group present. Right? Two or more hydroxy group present. For example, the first one is glucose. The formula of glucose is okay. Mute yourself, guys. Mute yourself, please. Okay. So you see, the formula of glucose is, we have aldehyde as the primary functional group, C double bond OH. Here we have OH, H, OH, H, OH, H, OH, H, and this side we have CH2OH. Okay, copy down this. This one here, we have CH2OH. This is C double bond O. And then we have HOH. Right side we have OH, OH. Left side we have H, H. And here we have CH2OH. This molecule, we call it as fructose, the another example of carbohydrate. Fructose. Okay. Now, what is the primary functional group in glucose? See, there are two functional group here. All of you try to understand here. One is alcohol, OH. So more than two or like two or more than two we have here. So it is polyhydroxy. And the another functional group is aldehyde. So aldehyde is the primary functional group because it is it dominates the alcohol, right? That's why this is the primary functional group we have. Similarly, here also we have polyhydroxy ketone, it is, right? And ketone dominates hydroxy. So this is also the primary functional group. Okay. So fructose, the primary functional group is ketone, and glucose, the primary functional group is aldehyde. Is it clear? Yeah. Okay. So these structures you must know. One thing also you must take care of here, that the last four carbon of glucose and fructose have same configuration. You see here, this part, this part and this part have same configuration here. Okay, so that you must keep in mind, that the last four carbon, okay, have the same configuration. Why I'm talking about configuration here? Because this carbon, you see, all these carbons are chiral carbon. If you try to, you know, observe this, this carbon is a chiral carbon. This carbon is a chiral carbon. This carbon is a chiral carbon. And this carbon is a chiral carbon. Yes or no? Here also, this carbon is a chiral carbon. This is a chiral carbon. And this is a chiral carbon. And that's why in the definition we have optically active polyhydroxyaldehyde or ketone. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
So PFG is?
Sorry?
So PFG is?
PFG is primary functional group.
Functional group, yeah.
Or principal functional group. Because aldehyde dominates hydroxy alcohol. That's why. Principal functional group is aldehyde in glucose, and principal functional group is ketone in fructose.
Okay. Yes, so understood.
This is one thing. If you have a compound, like if I write down one compound this way, suppose we have ether linkage here, H, and here we have HOH. This is also polyhydroxy, okay? CH2OH here. Here we have OH, H, CH2OH, and hydrogen here. And here we have CHO and CHO. Okay. Now, when you do the acidic hydrolysis of this one, H plus H2O, okay, acidic hydrolysis, right? So the reaction takes place at this ethyl oxygen, right? So simply you can write this way, that this combines with H, more electronegative goes with less, and less goes with more. This carbon oxygen bond breaks, and the product we get here is what? The product is this. We have OH, H, OH, H, CH2OH, CHO, and the other product we get is OH, H, H, OH, CH2OH, and CHO. You see, on hydrolysis.
So for the second one, why was the configuration flipped? For the second one, won't you just get two diastereomeric forms?
No, I am not talking about configuration here, whatever it is. Right? I have just written this way. Just this bond breaks, and I have written this way only. I'm not talking about enantiomers, diastereomers, whatever it is. Okay, that you let it be now. We'll come to that later. What I'm trying to make you understand here, that this molecule, okay, upon hydrolysis gives you polyhydroxyaldehyde. That's why this is also a carbohydrate. Okay, that's the definition we have.
And so one other question. This representation, aren't the glucose and fructose cyclic in nature? So this is post hydrolysis, right?
What? This is on hydrolysis.
This is on hydrolysis of glucose and fructose. We draw the structure, right?
These structures.
Yes, sir. These because
no.
Sir, but then aren't they cyclic in nature?
These two, yes, we have, but that we'll discuss. That's why fructose also shows tolerance test. Glucose, fructose, and mannose, they are in equilibrium. They are in a mixture. There you have all three forms you'll get.
Got it.
Yeah, we'll discuss that, Bharat. Just give me some time. We'll discuss that. We'll come to that. Now, just we are trying to understand here what the definition of carbohydrates. If you have ether linkage like this also, on hydrolysis, this also gives polyhydroxyaldehyde, right? That's why this compound is also carbohydrate.